Greetings, New Zealand naturopath Eric Packer here, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the Candida range of Candida dietary supplements. I'm answering a question here I just got on YouTube a few days ago. Eric, is herpes related to Candida? Can herpes cause Candida? Is there some association between them both? Well, no, not at all. Herpes is a virus, okay? Depends what kind of herpes we're talking. There's different kinds of herpes viruses. There's shingles, herpes zoster. We've got oral herpes. We've got genital herpes, you know, type 1 and 2. We've got chickenpox, which is a herpes virus. So there are various kinds of herpes viral strains that cause these problems. Viruses are notoriously hard to eradicate from the body because they are very, 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 very tiny. They have got an extremely tough protein outer coating, and the immune system can't really penetrate that coating. They also tend to hide in different parts of the body and can come out at certain times. You'll find with herpes, for example, from some research I did, herpes, particularly for the lips, the oral herpes, the herpes virus can hide in various parts of the spine, in various areas where poor blood supply, and it can come out at certain times and attack, you know, a particular site. And it's the same with the genital herpes. Again, that can sort of, you know, be harbored in the lower parts of the body and come out at set times. There are ways and means, though, for you to control herpes. And one of them is to have a diet high in arginine, the amino acid arginine-containing foods, and take out, the lysine foods, and take out the arginine amino acid-containing foods from your diet. Foods high in L-arginine that you need to avoid with herpes in particular are chocolate and nuts. Foods high in lysine are the meat foods, like chicken in particular is high in lysine, beef as well. So that's just a few tips. Stress is one of the biggest triggers I find for herpes, particularly the genital and the oral herpes. You'll find people under high stress eat chocolate, for example, and they get a cold sore coming up. So herpes, being a virus, has got no relationship with Candida, which is a fungus. Okay, so a yeast, a fungus, has nothing really to do with a virus. They're two separate entities. However, in saying that, I have found many people with herpes are more prone or more susceptible to getting Candida. And also the other way around, people with major yeast infections, it's more easy for them to catch herpes as well, especially if they're sexually active, you know, and they're in a relationship with someone who has got herpes or, you know, cold sores. So you can pick these things up. But you'll only pick them up if you've got a high susceptibility and low resistance. And that's what Candida will do. It will make your resistance low, so you are more prone to getting things like urinary tract infections and chest infections and all manner of infections. And it's particularly fueled by people with adrenal fatigue or people with cortisol problems. So lots of tiredness, sleeping disturbances, high stress. These things cause a lot of adrenal and thyroid malfunctions, which makes you a sitting duck for a yeast infection. And if you look at Candida Crusher, the book I wrote a whole section for this very reason on adrenal fatigue and Candida. And I think it was the missing link for a lot of people. Not many people knew about this until I started to really speak about it on YouTube and write about it. And I notice now some other blog sites are starting to do that. So it's not so much how do I get rid of Candida, it's how do I make my body strong so it's easy to beat. Not just Candida, but any kind of infection. And that's what you've got a good immune system for. The immune system will keep you healthy and strong, providing it's powered up. And what powers up your immune system in particular is a very well-functioning endocrine system or hormone system underpinning that. And how that can be optimized is by getting the balance between work and play, stress. Good diet, chilling out, not working too hard, not staying up too late on Facebook and things like this. These are good ways for you to power your immune system up, and particularly by improving your relationships with a lot of people around you, not getting stressed out about stuff. So I hope that answers your question. Thanks for tuning in.